Hi, I'm Henrik. In the second video for Figment UDIM Globe, I'm going to show you how we can use the batch exported UDIM textures that we created in the first tutorial and then import them into 3ds Max and apply them to one of the FBX spheres using VRay. So let's see if we can get these mapped in 3D. I'm just going to import these and navigate to the 3D model folder. And here we have three options. These are all basically the same, the only difference being the polygon count. So let's go with the middle one, the 1 million version, and import that. So this is just a basic sphere, but what's special about it is the included UV channels and coordinates. And next up, we're gonna load in the textures we just exported from Photoshop. So just select any one of these, doesn't really matter which. And the way it works with VRay is that you just select these four last digits in the name, the coordinate, and then you replace that with sharp bracket UDIM and sharp bracket. This will tell VRay that this is in fact a series of images with corresponding UDIM coordinates. And just set the correct color spaces and UV channel one, that's correct. So let's create a simple material from this, like so, and drag it onto the sphere. So this doesn't look great, but we can fix this. I have prepared a 4K version of the same texture. So this is just the same earth texture, but in a single map. And what we can do with that is we can Control V, copy this, and make another object. Apply this new material to it. Whoops, I need to change the UV channel to 2. There we go. That's the sort of regular mapping, if you will. And we can hit this, use full resolution. So this won't look great in close-up, but it's good enough to navigate with. And if I just open my navigator here, so for the preview object, I'm gonna right-click object properties and then disable renderable. This way it'll show up in the viewport, but it won't render. And if I select the other one, the hero object, I'm just gonna go into object properties for that one and then enable display as box. So this way we won't get any sort of intersection happening when we navigate and view here. We'll just view the preview globe, but render the hero globe. I just want to do a few more simple tweaks in here before I hit render. First off, I'm going to change the color management to OpenColor.io to Aces. This doesn't have anything to do with the UDIM workflow. This is simply to make stuff a bit prettier when we start rendering it. And for the preview here, this is a bit dark. A way to fix that is to simply add in a little bit of self-illumination here. This is just the viewport. And for the hero globe here, I'm gonna add in a composite map. And this will also be useful a little bit later. So let's put in a V-Ray color, set it to sRGB, and I already picked out some values that I liked in here, something like that. Okay. All right, let's add some lights. V-Ray sunlight, and no thank you to the environment map. Boost intensity to 5 and select direct for the color mode and then invisible. And I'll add a V-Ray dome light just to add a bit of light into the shadows. Okay, now we should have something like this. And if we zoom in, we should have some pretty good resolution to look at. And you can just navigate this around. Okay, so this is looking pretty cool. However, there is one issue that I want to point out. And if we just go to the Pacific here, you'll see this annoying vertical line down the middle here. And this is a seam that even with all my best efforts, I haven't been able to fix inside the UV coordinates. I'm not sure if this is simply a lack of skills on my part or if this is something that's an inherent issue with the way that UDIMs work. However, I do have a fix for it. So the low resolution texture we have up here, that is mapped to UV channel 2. If we go down here to our hero shader and simply plug this below all the other maps, this will fix it. I wish there didn't need to be a workaround for this issue, but here we are. If you're watching this and thinking, oh, Henrik, you just needed to push the duh button, please do let me know. I love to learn. All right, so now that that is fixed, I'm going to show you something that I think is pretty neat when working with UDIMs. So I'm just going to navigate to the UDIM Globe folder, and I've included these overlay guides. Let's just pick the one down here that's clean. And make sure that this is set to map channel 2 as well. And plug it in here into the composite map. And I'll just change this to addition. So the idea is that if you need to work on a specific part of the texture and you're not quite sure which UDIM you're looking at, then you can just look directly at your globe and then conclude that, well, Australia, which is the one I want to focus on right now, well, that's 1017 and 1018. So it kind of just removes the guesswork from that. All right, so now I'm going to show you what I think is really neat about working with UDIMs, and that is that you don't need to load all the tiles. You can just load the ones that you actually need. So I'm just gonna open up the task manager here. So you can see right now all of the tiles are loaded and I'm using about 20 gigs of memory for this 3ds Max session. And let me just stop the render and I'm going to create a temp folder and I wanna work on Australia only. So I just wanna have the 1017 and 1018 tile. So I'm gonna select everything in here, except 17 and 18, and simply drag them in here. So now V-Ray and Max don't know where they are. And when I go in here and hit reload, then we should see something happening here in the memory consumption. I think I need to render before this is flushed. So I'm just gonna go in here and then disable the low resolution earth that's below here. And I'm going to disable the overlay. So when I hit render now, I am hoping I'll only see these two tiles. And then I'm hoping that the memory consumption should go down. So let's see what happens. And there we go. So around 6 versus the 20 we were using before. And obviously we need to enable this again. This is just the 4K earth and we're still at 6 gigs. So if I go in here now and zoom in, we still have all the pristine detail from these two high resolution tiles. But if we go down to, I think this cuts off at, yeah, here you can see it, it cuts off at New Zealand. Hi, this is Editor Henrik. I just want to point out that while I love the simplicity of using the VRayBitmap to load all the UDIMs in at once, if you do need to pick out specific UDIMs and you're working across different projects using the same textures, it's probably not a great idea to mess around inside the texture folder. So I'm just going to quickly show you another approach where you have a lot more control on a scene-by-scene basis of which textures you're actually loading. All right, so I'm just going to go to Maps, General, Multitile, and then in the file pattern, I'm going to select UDIM. Open up the textures and just select any one of these. Right now I have all 32 inside the folder and now we just wait for them all to load. Okay, so now we have 32 bitmap loaders, one for each of the UDIM tiles. So this is a lot messier, but it also gives you more control. So if I just zoom in here, then you can see that each of these is loading a different UDIM tile. So let's find the ones for Australia, 1018, 1017, and then I'm just gonna delete the rest of these. Okay, so these are standard bitmaps. We want to convert them to V-Ray bitmaps. We can do that by going to the V-Ray menu up here, Converters, Bitmap to V-Ray Bitmap, and Convert. Next up, we want to change the sRGB or the color space to sRGB for both of these. And now we can replace the old one up here, the VRayBitmap. Let me just disable this one so we can check that we actually have what we had before. And there we are. So this way we keep all the textures intact inside the folder. And let's just enable the background again, and that's it. So yeah, I think UDIMs can be a really powerful part of your workflow, and I hope you'll find this toolkit useful. Please do share if you do something cool with it. And yeah, that's it for me. Thanks for watching.